Hello. Pretty tired of this light lately. See what happens, man. Oh, that guy at the trailer's probably gonna flip it. Yeah. Anyone that cuts that fucking corner, man. Oh, I need to roll my shorts up a little bit here. I still haven't trimmed the seat post clamp on this thing. Thanks. Short ride today. I'm just going over to Sehmel to kind of clarify things in my mind there. This is great because I could just space out. I don't have to worry about this intersection. Anyway, it turns out 74th is a private road south of Sehmel. But I missed an entrance to the park. I'm like blind, not paying attention. I was so laser focused on the roads, especially 74th, I didn't even see the entrance right next to it. I'll reiterate that when I'm over there in case someone skips ahead just to that part or something. Finish this road, get rid of the steel plate. This is a bad place to be on the wrong side of the road, so I just have to get in the middle of the lane here. Thank you. dragging my heels a lot today. I don't know what that means. Making a left at Hunt. I've never done that since they redid the sidewalk. I don't know what's going on. Try and stay at a dip next time. Just in case there's rubble in there, you know? I'm in a stupid place right now. Don't like it. Signaled. I can't do the helmet mirrors because my glasses, it's out of my field of view. I don't really care what's behind me anyway. I used to keep it on the left side of my handlebars, but I don't know, I just watched it the whole time. Bro, I watched that more than I watched in front of me, so fuck it. Not really looking forward to this four-way stop. Silver car. It's nice when it's clear who goes next and everyone actually goes. Makes it a lot easier on me. Because when you're dealing with elevation in an intersection like that, you don't want people fucking up your track stand or whatever, you know? Doesn't say no filming. Yeah, I like doing that left turns apparently, doing it all day. It's the only time I ride on the wrong side of the road if I can help it. I do it in the city too. Like Fife, some of the intersections are such a bitch. There's always a gas station you can cut through. You just gotta be hyper-vigilant because people aren't expecting you to be where you're at. Car behind me, I don't know what they're doing. left side of the road, 74th, is a private road. Thanks. Here's the park entrance I was too stupid to see. So you don't have to bother the neighbors over there. You don't have to talk to keep off my lawn guy. He's watching, I apologize. I'm not gonna go knock on his door and get a gun pulled on me, but I'm sorry for trespassing on your dear property. I think this is much better than walking up a hill. And if we do get to walk up a hill, it's going to be in shade. It only works on this bike though, because it's got the fat back tire. I don't like pushing it with the skinny tires. I'm so heavy. And I tend to break spokes and shit, so. And this part right here, I remember is actually just about soft camber. Find my tracks from last time. Trying to use my coaster brake, trying to get my brain into that. It's very strange. Of a coaster brake as a mountain biker. What a trip. Just stop out here somewhere in the cliff bar. Bridge over there. Maybe we go over there for a break. I think I'll walk down there though. I don't know if we're gonna get anything scenic or a little creek, but we're probably likely to get mosquitoes, so yeah, this is more single track, even though it's a little wider than normal. I actually like how they drop the trees in here. It makes it better habitat for stuff. But I tell you, it's mainly a mosquito habitat. I don't see them or hear them yet. Now this one definitely ends in a private road, so practically there's no way you can ever get to this from outside. Even though the neighbors on this end don't give a shit. Secluded place. Maybe we'll go right here. I don't think I share the bike from this side very often. The Shimano commuter ring. Picked up a hotline sticker from Terry. I'm sinking in the muck here. Anyways, this is late 80s, I can't remember. 89, 91, Japanese built Schwinn. 25 inch frame, all chrome molly except for the fork. It's running a 4420 single speed with coaster brake and my little stealthy cross brake lever there. No, the coaster brake's fun on the trails. It feels like it feels like you're doing something wrong, actually. Sure is fun though. Muggy out today. It's supposed to be super hot there this week, but we got one more muggy day tomorrow. Might even have some rain tomorrow. Actually, I bought this bike with this coaster brake and drivetrain on. I just changed the back gear to the 22 from 18. And I put the fixation tires on it. And then the one thing, besides the tires, it had this white deal here. And it didn't match anything. Which I think the guy liked that it looked that way. He kind of had trashy parts on here. And he had a bar that came up. He cut a road bar and turned it upside down. And so I put the bars in seat post and saddle on it. I like these, but they're a little racy for me. And I'm not quite in shape enough to a full race mode seat, but we're getting there. Oh, this tire on the back, I mean, if I wanted to get the bike under, 10 kilos, I'd probably have to get rid of that tire. Or I can keep the tire and get rid of the wheel. Maybe. I think I'm just going to keep it where it is. It's just a hair under 15 pounds. Am I talking shit with kilograms? No, this bike weighs just over 15 pounds with the blinky light on it, just under without it. Maybe I'm talking shit. And it's 25 pounds and 15. You know, it's funny because I almost rode it right here. Sharpie, I probably should do that because I'm such a fucking dumbass, I can't remember shit. £25, I bet you. Probably 10.5 kilograms. Whatever. Math. Some math. Be a good place to take a break if you're coming like 300 mile a day or something. Either one stretch to the house. I suppose in that case you could even just walk your bike on the trail. Just chill out. What was I saying last time about finding places you have all yourself? Even better when there's no neighbor chasing you down, yelling, "Get off my lawn." After you're already off it. 74th on the other side of the road is a county right away, and actually that's not a bad place to go explore. Like walk all the way down, you can get to two roads to go to views of the water, and so county right away the whole way down, and not all the way to the water, but until you get to the cul-de-sacs. And the right away ends at Sehmel, and these people punched a private road in for their property access and have easements. And so the signage is representative of the county road on the other side of the road, not having to do with 74 south of Sehmel. Now, it's not trespassing unless I... Washington's kind of weird. You have to know you're trespassing, apparently. Must be why people with signs up. But, visually impaired cyclist making a determination based on current county guidelines. Pretty reasonable to assume. I was just ignorant and trying to figure it out. And once I learned the truth, I respect his rights. Sure's a dick, though. I love cedar groves, man. I was really hoping to find a little cedar grove to camp in when I was in the Olympics, but we'll still have time. 2 weeks until the... 3 weeks until my Cascades trip, though. I do think I have to walk up part of this trail because it gets steep over by the David Day Road. Nice detour though. It's so great because it just like shifts your gear. I do like some of the fast-paced riding on the road where you gotta be aggressive and stuff. I can't lie, I do like it. I'd rather there just weren't people around. It was quiet, like this. Hello. I'm gonna try to jump this time. I got a little excited last time, but this front wheel, man, it's so funny. Not a lot of authority. I'm just kind of gravel. Speaking of that, I need to really lighten the coaster brake here. I think a little moisture would help. This bridge would get slippy, but I think the rocks are probably worse for a bike. This corner might be sketched, that one right there. Ooh, loose, loose, loose. All right, let's see. This bike just loves this shit, though. Ooh, thank you. off camera. Yeah, I just don't think. If you charged on that boardwalk and hit that off camber part right in the middle where it's on camber, maybe you could do this standing up. It doesn't feel like a defeat though in the woods like it does on the road. Have a little walk. We'll see. Makes me kind of excited about going this way again, because I was getting tired of it on the way home every time. Just have to watch out for that dickhead neighbor. He's just out in his truck or something, wants to extract a pound of flesh. Bye, my property. All right, buddy. Whew. Unfortunately, this intersection is busy here. Oh shit. Oh. I shoot down that four-way. The coaster break is. I always wanted one of those police hubs that has the silent pause in it. Pause. I like that the coaster break's silent, but you can have one of those police hubs on all your bikes, you know. Complete opposite of Terry and his fucking monster loud. Calls. The camera's not too high for that. I tried to aim to the right, but I didn't aim down at all. Think about it. I do kind of wish I had a gimbal. I love the idea of just having the simple GoPro strapped to your chest. But there's a lot of times I'm not too happy with the. Like my last video was low light in the woods, kinda. It was really dark that day. I didn't change the settings, it was still just ISO 100 with the polarizer on. And it's like I couldn't do the hyper smooth with the fucking, with that dark. It's like I just stopped doing it, I don't know. I also switched back to 4K 30 because it's not a variable. I had put it on 24. I don't think a gimbal would make more work for me or anything as long as it didn't break. So. I love this gear so much. It's better for this road than whatever gear I choose on the 10 speed normally. It's so funny. And it's also funny how the 4418 was just way too much for me. I was walking everywhere. I lost a little weight. I'm gonna ride in this thing a little more. I know that helps, but still, two teeth helps a lot. I have a 22 tooth at home, but I know going to a 22 would be too much the other way. Thanks, car. I wish I could use the coaster brake turning on the rain ash. I just don't use the rear brakes on the road. I don't mind at a stop sign or whatever, but you mean it. I wish it was easier to make that turn going down the hill. Because you could just sail up this, but then a lot of times there's a car coming and you gotta yield the right of way and you're going 30 miles an hour. And so, I mean, what makes the most sense is to take control of the lane and then stop on the left side, like right by the line. It's also a good way to get hit by a car. Scare people. If it was a trail, I'd have to make noise, you know, but just kind of get over a little bit. Give them room. I'm trying to scare the hell out of them. A good habit, so I'm not swinging out. I This road's pretty great with this gear too. I think a lot of times I'm conflicted. I'm probably getting a big ring already here, and I'm too high for this little bump. Come on, buddy. I don't know, man. The guy just sitting like 100 yards behind me going like 10 miles an hour in a Volkswagen, silver Volkswagen. Let's see if he passes me here, if it's the same guy. Here's somebody. I always wait until this blind corner to do it. You ready? At least no one's coming this time. He's still getting up the guts. There we go. That's a sewer. I'm pretty sure it's the same car. Because I felt him there throughout the whole thing. It's pretty sunny today. I'm kind of glad I didn't go farther. I do want to ride in the sun maybe on Thursday again. Next week, I'm going to have to do some longer rides though. In the sun with the red 10 speed. At this point, I feel like this bike fits me better than the red one. We'll see though. I think the bars helped a lot. Should probably put sunscreen on for next week. Thursday should be under 2 hours. I'll probably get a little bit of burning, but not much. I don't try and get base tans generally, but I do like if my arms and legs don't need sunscreen. If I ever saw a lawn for an electric mower, maybe he has a huge backyard down by the creek or something. I could probably do that thing with my 4 amp hour batteries. I'm very impressed with my DeWalt electric mower. I got it in 2020, I think, so. It's the older, narrower one. I would like to get the new one just so I can use the old one for dumb shit. Like shit you should be using a weed whacker for. And I can use the new one for the grass. Because right now, I mean, the gas mowers have just been sitting and they don't start anymore. I'm just gonna give them away. There's no going back, dude. But I would like to have two electric just so I could have a backup in case something happened and I can do dumb shit without worrying about it. But it also make me behave safer, because I know I'm gonna do dumb shit. I might put on my steel toes when I grab the shitty mower. And if I'm having a nice mower, I'll just be mowing flat stuff and I'm dangling off a fucking cliff or something stupid. It won't cut my toes off. Whew, pretty warm. Oh, there's a little headwind now that I'm getting up this little hill. Ah, oh, comes and goes. Pretty stagnant, humid air with this heat coming off the blacktop, man. I was really worried about getting heat adapted this year, and then the summer just didn't happen. And so now it's practically July. And we've had like two hot days the whole year, and this one's just, you know, alright. It's not too hot, but feels hot because no one's used to it. So I don't know how next week was gonna go, but I think I've got a 36 mile deal. And if I can do that without having heat stroke or bonking. I could turn that same ride into a 70-mile deal pretty easily, looking towards a century later. It might end up being later than season. I was hoping to do it earlier, but so there's definitely a strength element to this. So I just charged that fucking hill without even charging it, without standing up. And I'm barely out of breath. That's a new development. Also, I did less miles today, I suppose. I had oatmeal an hour before I rode. So it could be the reduced mileage and the dialed in nutrition today. Felt like strength at the time. I also think just riding three times a week, even if it's not as long as you wanted, has profound benefits for your cycling. I mean, this won't even be 20 miles, but I definitely feel like I'm gonna benefit from it. I feel like I just witnessed some benefits of the habit already there on that hill. So I think shooting for higher mileage and not riding because you're like saving yourself or something stupid is a really dumb idea. I was doing that earlier in the season. And I had that bonk on the red bike. Took a month off at the end of the semester. I was just so overwhelmed. Didn't ride for almost a month. Isn't heavy today. I don't think I can blame the backpack, so. I think it's just my neck. Shitty posture. I don't know if I've experienced enough personal growth yet to do this hill on a single speed. I don't even know what strategy is best. Well, there you have it. I regret it though. see you guys in the next one.